It's discard two. Wait, no, it's not. It's another casually competitive deck tech with Thunder. Welcome back to another episode. So I'm kind of doing this for Chip. He has asked me to make sure that I'm banging out these deck techs as quickly as I can, just to give you guys as many options to play at a casually competitive level. So taking a look here, we're going to start off with a deck that is near and dear to my heart, something that I have worked on since the previous meta, and it really wasn't good in the previous meta. It just didn't have enough there. It was too slow. It didn't have access to blue. It was just too much going against it. But I think with the addition of the rotation and the new set, I think that this deck has a little bit more tools to do what it wants to do, as well as it does take a little bit more time for certain matchups to develop. So what I mean by that is the game has slowed down slightly. Now, taking a look, we are rolling out with Rose, Jedha Partisan, long-term plan. So we did see this deck the beginning of, like, Way of the Force meta, I believe. Yep, Way of the Force, that's when long-term plan came out. People were really surprised by how well it did. It was a deck that could mill you or kill you with spikes of damage. And really, the main engine in the deck is long-term plan. So if you're not aware of it, a long-term plan says, exhaust this plot to place one resource on it, or to resolve one of your dice, increasing its value by the number of resources on this plot. So turn one, we're just going to pop it, we're going to turn it sideways, and we're going to put a resource on it. Turn two, now we can increase the value of one of our dice by one. If we make it out of turn two, which we will, we can increase the value of two. So it just makes things a little bit more explosive. The longer you go, the more dangerous this card becomes. So there are times that you might want to use it a little bit early and then kind of forego, you know, being able to tick it up. But I still think it's a really underrated card, especially in this current meta. And then as for the battlefield here, it's upside down, so that kind of threw me off. It says resolve one of your dice, increasing its value by one if you could spot a plot. So these two kind of work hand in hand. There aren't going to be very many times where we claim, but this is just one of those battlefields that kind of helps us and might marginally help our opponent depending on what deck they're playing, but certainly can help our overall agenda. So let's just get right into the deck. Let's look at the characters again. So Rose, she's going to make us money with her specials. She has the two indirect to kind of pop off the ability from the Jedha Partisans. We're going to be running her at two dice at 11 points, and that's basically what she brings to the table. She also has that discard side, which is super relevant when it comes to the mill win condition. And then we have two Jedha Partisans. Now, they are 8 health for 8 play cost. They have two indirect sides on them. They have that discard side, the resource. Indirect, not super relevant, but it says after you deal indirect damage to your opponent for the first time each turn, you may discard a top card of their deck. So this triggers both of our Jedha Partisans, so anytime we do indirect damage, it's actually two cards off the top of their deck. Now, to start off, your opponent is going to want to go after Rose because this is a support deck. The way that we're going to deal the majority of our damage is through the supports in the deck. So their first instinct is going to be to go after Rose, but really that becomes kind of like a counterintuitive plan because the Jedha Partisans are really kind of like the characters that are going to win the kind of the battle of attrition. They are going to whittle down your opponent's deck over and over again. And, it becomes frustrating for your opponent because their options start to become more and more limited as they go on. So another great thing about this and long-term plan is we can spike any of our dice. So late game, if you're looking for a push to push out some damage or to solidify the mill win condition, you can certainly, tap your long-term plan and then target one of these discard sides that we have on each of our characters, and you can discard, three cards out of their hand going late game. So that's super relevant when they're trying not to get milled out or when you're trying to maximize the potential of your turn. So looking at the upgrades, we don't have very many. We have 5 total. We have 2 copies of Riot Shield. I just seem to be putting this in a lot of different decks. It is kind of like a callback to, some of the upgrades that would block some damage, armored plating. This is probably most relevant or most best compared to. I like to say it's like a little force illusion for some of the other colors, but I get ragged on for saying that. But it's still good just to keep our characters alive a little bit better. Two copies of the new card. It's Resistance Ring. So die sides are, you know, to be desired, but it says after you play this card, you can discard the top card of a deck, so it's going to be your opponent in this instance. And then the special is play a red event from any discard pile that is either yours or your opponent's, and then you do have to pay the cost. So that's just something to keep in mind. You do have to pay the cost of it, but it is pretty cool that we can kind of bring back some of these red events that we do have in our deck or our opponent's deck. And then we got the one copy of Handheld Cannon. It just helps to kind of push the agenda of dealing damage. I just think this card is so busted. I put it in a lot of different decks. And it works really well with the supports. The range side can kind of match up with some of the supports that we have and deal a decent amount of damage. So moving on to the supports of the deck, kind of the meat and potatoes here. I got two copies of Tech Team. Works really well. I have gone back and forth with like Tech Team, Scrap Heap. I've run some lists that have both in them, but I consider just cutting the Scrap Heap and putting the Tech Team in. Kind of just helps us out with the agenda of getting the supports on board. We got one copy of Senate Chamber. Really good. It allows us to focus into the damage if we want to go that route. And it is helpful when it comes to mill because it can mitigate a die. It also has that discard side on it. So really good. It is awesome, too, if you're going for like a late game push and you long-term plan one of these two focus sides. So you can easily turn that into like four focus and just focus up all of your dice and then hit for max damage. So super good card for utility. I'd like to run two copies, but they did make it unique, so it's kind of tough and feels a little bit clunky at that point. One copy, again, same thing for this. It's Anakin Skywalker's Pod Racer. I would run two copies, but it gets a little clunky. When you do see it, it feels awesome. When you don't, it's not that great, but I'd like to see it a little bit more often. I was considering putting in that card that kind of like searches out Pod Racers just to not have two dead cards in my hand. But it says after. It has ambush, it has all these cool little, mill sides, but it says after you resolve this die, you may discard the top card of your deck if you spot Anakin Skywalker. We don't have him, so it's basically we resolve it, and then we get to discard top card of a deck. So really good. It's just a lot of utility. I always love resolving like the two shield side or the discard side. So those are obviously the best sides on the die. We got two copies of Resistance Crate Speeder. Now, this is the kind of real, as far as value goes, heavy hitter in the deck. And I mean value when it comes to, how much it costs in resources and then how much damage it can really do. So it says before you resolve this die, if the support has no damage on it, you may increase place one damage on it and increase the value of the die side. So really, if it has no damage on it and we're doing it for the first time, this is a two-range, three indirect, two shields, two money, and a blank. And then what works really well with this is Rose's special, which is gain one resource, then you may remove one damage from a support. So it makes this kind of like increase in value be super live for multiple turns. So that's why we have it in this deck. Two copies of N1 Starfighter. Now, I'm just a big fan of the card for two reasons. It has the ability to blow up other supports that are on board, specifically the vehicle supports that are on your opponent's side of the board. It has decent damage sides, all base damage sides, nothing we have to pay for. And it has a two shield side. So I think it's really good with what we're trying to do for the deck. You know, when we have long-term plan with two resources on it, this side can be easily, four damage, five damage, whatnot. So it becomes a really good value there. And then we get into the real heavy hitter of the deck as far as supports go, and it's the V-Wing. So I think it's just a lot of great value for a three cost. There are some sides that we do have to pay for, but I think that it's really not that big of an issue, considering that if we're able to long-term plan these sides, it's a huge value. So it says, while a hero vehicle die is in your pool, this die cannot be removed by opponents. So that's even more frightening for your opponents. They're going to have to get through one of your other hero vehicle dice before they can touch this one. It kind of acts like a pseudo triple laser turret for your your other vehicles. So this side's, with the long-term plan, sky's the limit, but, easily we can get it off to, like, this is a five-ranged, five-ranged, five, or th- four, Discard for one. So it's super good. You know, I look at everything with like a long-term plan of like a two increase. You know, really good value there. Hits really hard. So that's it for the upgrades and the supports. Let's look at some of the events in the deck. So this was something I was really kind of excited to add to the deck. This was something that wasn't obviously you know, the previous meta. This is brand new from Convergence. It's No Answer. It says discard a random card from an opponent's hand. If that opponent has no cards in their hand, discard the top three cards of their deck. So if you think about it, this becomes an extremely, by adding this into the deck, it becomes an extremely aggressive mill kind of win condition. But it's only a couple cards here and there, and it doesn't really feel like it's fully committed to mill, but it is. You know, just by looking at our characters, they obviously don't look like mill characters. And then the situations that you'll find yourself in when it comes to, you know, how many cards your opponent has or how much deck they have left after like round three, you'll be really surprised. And cards like No Answer in tandem with Resistance Ring really help to push that overall objective of like it is our secondary win condition, but can just as easily become our primary win condition. So be aware of that. And No Answer just really pushes it even further along. We have two copies of Well Connected. So the reason I like this card so much is we do need a little bit of resource generation. It is nice to have, considering that we are a support deck and we're a little bit slower at generating resources along the way. But it's spot a yellow character, so we have two yellow characters to kind of ensure that it's zero cost, and it also requires that our opponent draws a card. So the good thing about that is it digs a little bit deeper into their deck, and considering that we have probably a stronger mill con or discard mill you know, condition than we do actually getting into the deck. I know that we have the partisans that get into the deck, but it is you know, easier for us to kind of spike some discard sides or hit them with like a no answer. So a really cool play actually with both of these cards, that's why I put them together, is they have no cards left in hand, and then you play Well Connected, you gain that additional resource if you didn't have it, and then you play No Answer, and it's like they drew into a card, they discard that card, and they discard the top three, so it becomes four total cards. No Answer usually is four total cards, but it just increases No Answer, you know, it spices it up that much more with these two, and that situation has kind of come up with me, so I just wanted to bring it up. It's not the best, most big, you know, backbreaking play, but it's pretty good. Next, we have one copy of Entangled, so a really good mitigation card. I'd like to add two, but the deck is kind of I don't want to say tight on resources, but everything either cost one resource or you know, up, and there's not many zero cost you know, cards in this deck, so we really need to make sure that we're not clogging up the deck too much with too many resource dependent card. So we just have the one Entangled. So this is the only zero cost in the whole entire deck, and it is two copies of Crash Landing. Now we want to be able to spread you know, the damage through any of our characters, with Vader not being you know, probably not being a huge force in this current meta. You know, Crash Landing becomes really good because we can just kind of spread apart that damage, and we don't have to worry about a die getting rolled back in, unless that's Palpatine and you know, one of his force storms. But I still think this card is really good and worth the include. We got two copies of Into the Garbage Chute. So this is where it like becomes a straight up, you know, like mill deck. Like anytime you see Into the Garbage Chute as like some viable mitigation, you know, the deck is kind of leaning a little bit towards that mill condition. But just really good. We can you know, exhaust one of our Jedha partisans, you know, whatnot. Still get the effect of their ability because it doesn't matter about, you know, resolving their dice. This still would trigger both of their abilities, and we're able to exhaust one of them and block up to two dice showing damage. So still a really great mitigation card. I'm glad that it's you know, a nice addition to this deck. Two copies of Scruffy Looking Nerf Herder. So it says for one resource, choose one of the following types. An event, a support, an upgrade. Then look at an opponent's hand and discard a card from that hand of the chosen type. So it's just a great utility card to kind of get into the hand a little bit more. This is, like I said, it can attack the hand probably a little bit better, or more like a spike of hand a disruption more frequently than it can the deck. But we're trying to kind of just get into that hand and throw our opponent off. Anytime that we can take something like a key piece that your opponent really wanted to lay down, whether that be a support against a support deck or an upgrade against, you know, an aggro deck, it really does set them back and hurt a little bit. Two copies of Easy Pickings. Now this has fallen out of the limelight of being like the best you know, event as far as mitigation goes, but I still think it's really good. People are still playing it. I'm not to say that it's not good anymore. It's just I don't hear too many people talk about Easy Pickings, but it's still really good. And we have two copies here in the deck, and then we have two copies of the old school OG Field Medic art. So you can pick up your new art of Field Medic and jam it in this deck, but we have two copies. This just helps a little bit along the way. You know, if they're looking to spike Rose turn two, it allows her to get to turn three. Now, a realistic expectation for Rose is she will go down turn two. That's kind of fine for us. There are times where she's pretty much done her job by, you know, resolving her dice twice. Anytime they mitigate her dice, it does kind of hurt a little bit because she is the full utility package of the deck. She provides the discard, she provides the indirect, but most importantly, she provides that ramp. I will say, anytime that you see Rose going into like the third round, or if she can get herself to a fourth round of play, you're pretty much going to mill your opponent. It's a mill win condition because, like I said, she is the primary target. Now, you can mess around with some of these events if you don't like this. If you want to go more of like the zero cost events, you could certainly do that. I have seen a card, it's like Fight Fire with Fire. It allows us to remove one of our indirect sides to remove a side showing damage on their side. It just seems a little counterintuitive to me, but there really isn't too much in yellow red as far as zero cost mitigation goes, so this is kind of what we have to work with. You can obviously put in cards like Flank in here, you know, that works. You can put in cards like, I have been messing around with the card Emulate. Emulate is basically, if you could spot two characters with the same title, which is Jedha Partisans, you could turn one of those character dice to any side. So it just helps if you want to like spike someone's hand or you need to pop off the indirect. It's very helpful in that aspect. But let me know what you think of the deck. It's super fun. It's it can mill someone at a quick rate. It is pretty wild how fast it does mill. And like I said, if you can get to like turn three, you'll look and your opponent will look down and they'll have like you know, eight to ten cards left in their deck and not even realize it, because they don't enter the matchup thinking that this is a straight mill deck. They see you start putting down supports like the Resistance Crate Speeder or the N1, and then they start kind of gearing their playstyle towards a damage dealing support deck, and it's simply just not the case. So you know, we can certainly spike characters and kill them with these cards, but you know, we do have that mill undertone. So it kind of does both very effectively, and you'll see how it'll put your opponent on their back foot, because they both now have to watch out for damage swings, and they also have to watch out for massive swings of discard. And the greatest part about long-term plan is your opponent never knows which approach you're going to take in that round. So if you consider this, you know, long-term plan at round three has two resources on it. We can either spike for huge amounts of damage, or we can spike for their entire hand. There are some situations where we could just get a lot of value out of it. So commonly, I've been able to take like three cards out of their hand. You know, that works out pretty well. Or I've been able to hit for swings of five damage. So check out the deck. Let me know what you think. Be sure to listen to us on Discard to Reroll, the podcast. We're going to try to get out as more episodes at a more frequent basis. But stay tuned. Also, wanted to kind of introduce, I don't know when this video is going to post, but also introduce our new addition to Discard Reroll. That is Josh Monk, also known as Banana Crapshoot. Really great guy, you know, dear friend of mine, and certainly someone that we're glad to have on to Discard Reroll. So check out the deck. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you next time on the next episode. Take care.